So let's look at gold. Well, January 21st, 1980, gold was at $850 an ounce. Doesn't sound like a very good inflationary protection to me.
Because the potential of a bubble is clearly existent.
But the two interviewers were kind of ridiculing him, telling him that gold was a bubble and so forth.
Gold and silver taking a sharp turn to the downside.
Is the gold trade right now, it's dead.
How much of that rise was based on fundamentals and how much speculation?
Speculation.
That signaled the end of the gold bull.
You know, a lot of people wonder whether the bull run in gold is over.
But doesn't that kind of set us up for an enormous risk of a fall?
If gold goes up no matter what's happening, that's a bubble.
Gold futures posted their biggest one-day loss since January 1980.
When gold ran the last time, 1966 to 1980.
1980.
Is this really 1980 all over again? 1971, President Nixon closed the gold window, taking the dollar off what was left of the gold standard. Shortly thereafter, in 1974, Americans were allowed to officially purchase gold bullion for the first time since 1933, when FDR made it illegal. With inflation on the rise from Vietnam and new entitlement spending, gold buyers in the mid-1970s found themselves in the perfect storm. Gold rallied until it reached bubble mania. Average everyday people purchase gold in order to make a profit. Does this look like 1980 to you? Not even close. In 1980, the Federal Reserve's key lending rate was in the teens. Today, it's around 0%. The US government was trying to tame inflation. Today, economists are worried about deflation and advocating for more inflation.
Keynesian economists, they've always argued that inflation after a doldrum recession is good.
Some inflation is necessary.
Paul Volcker was in charge of the Federal Reserve. Today, it's Helicopter Ben. Need we say more? By the early 1980s, after 204 years as a nation, the United States had an official debt of around $1 trillion. The last trillion added to the national debt in 2011 only took 7 months. In 1980, gold had just been officially retired as a currency in the previous decade. Today, gold has been accumulated by nations for currency diversification. In 1980, there are stories of gold shops that had lines stretched outside their doors. Today, Americans are lined up outside We Buy Gold stores to sell their gold. Sure, there are gold companies on news stations, but the massive public participation needed to fuel a bubble isn't there. When Cash for Gold is running ads on Super Bowl Sunday, that's a sign that the public is completely ignorant of the gold bull market. Remember, Cash for Gold is a company that buys gold from the public.
Goodbye, old friend.
In fact, CBS did a report recently that showed the public not only selling gold, but selling it for 10 cents on the dollar to companies like Cash for Gold.
And what was the company's offer? Far from top dollar, it was the lowest offer of all.
This is the exact opposite of a gold bubble and shows that the only public participation we are seeing in the gold market is to sell gold, not buy it. Those that are buying gold are not treating it as just another investment to make a profit. They are buying gold to protect themselves. They are using gold as a hedge against the entire fiat currency system itself. For the past 40 years, Americans have been brainwashed into believing gold is nothing more than a decoration. And that it is the fiat currency controlled by a small group of bankers that is the ideal medium of exchange. This system of debt is coming to its end, and this is the biggest difference between 1980 versus today. Whether you accept the fate of the dollar and its destiny with real value makes no difference to the global powers that are making their moves right now. Russia and Iran have replaced the US dollar with their national currencies in bilateral trade. According to a report from Iran's state-run news agency, Russia was the nation that proposed and pushed for this agreement. Iran has already replaced the dollar in its trade with India, China, and Japan. We should note that this could mean wars coming. Prior to the Iraq War in 2003, Saddam Hussein announced that Iraqi oil would only be sold for euros, not US dollars. Prior to the Libya invasion in 2011, Gaddafi had openly planned and advocated to install a gold-backed African currency in order to compete with the US dollar, even calling for other African and Middle Eastern nations to join him. The world's second and third largest economies also recently decided to bypass the dollar. China and Japan have recently engaged in direct currency trade. This means that instead of using the world's reserve currency as a medium of exchange, Japan and China will have direct trading without using US dollars. This will increase the exchange market for these two currencies and reduce the demand for US dollars. Having these two large economies make this move is probably one of the biggest blows of the US dollar in the past several years, and should be a clear warning sign to those that hold dollars that the luxury and safety of holding the reserve currency will not last forever. The big players are making their moves now. Remember, the same people who are telling you that gold is in a bubble are the same people who were telling you to buy the financials in 2008.
Well, the financials, as I keep saying, are just super bargains. I particularly like Merrill Lynch, which is an astonishingly well-run company. Bear is probably the cheapest, although the riskiest, and some of the others are better. But, you know, the financials are a great place, absolutely.
Don't move your money from Bear. That's just being silly. Don't be silly.
I like Goldman Sachs. It's like getting Dolce & Gabbana on sale. This is the creme de la creme of Wall Street. It's cheap.
It's a buying opportunity, especially for the financials, maybe that I've never seen before in my entire life.
Saving your wealth in dollars is a lot like making your bed in a burning house. Visit futuremoneytrends.com to download our free report on the future of the US dollar.